come along and join us for Musical Robot.
These robots must awake, but how? Children, can you help me now? It's simple. On the count of three, repeat these three small words with me.
Ready, set, robot! A robot came to Earth in search of fun. He wanted to be friends with everyone, but frightened kids, and so when he was done, he really didn't have a friend at all. Then when he was just about to go, he met ScottBot and Jason 2.0. They said, we'll help you know what you should know, and really we could kinda use a home. Musical robot, gonna explore and grow up a lot. Musical robot, we'll dance and sing and learn and love and play.
Welcome back, friends.
Jason 2.0 logging in. ScottBot logging in.
Good morning.
Good morning, musical robot. Ooh.
Thank you, robot.
Yeah. Musical robot?
Yes.
What just happened?
Confetti is fun.
Is it? because it really feels like you just covered our delicious breakfast in tiny, inedible bits of paper.
So that's not fun?
Well, not in this context.
Not fun in the context or situation of breakfast.
Yes. Yes.
Wow. Thanks, robot.
You're really good at stuff like that.
Let's eat.
Okay, glitter is...
Fun! It is sparkly! Sparkly is fun.
Sparkly is awesome. It's just anything in a pile on top of a delicious breakfast that you really want to eat is not fun.
Affirmative.
Wow, thanks, robot.
Yeah, you're really good at that. Let's eat.
Wait.
Okay, robot, that was fun.
Breakfast mess.
Oh, that's no problem. The robo hair repair unit cleaned us up lickety fizz.
Oh, hey, Rudy. The musical robot is having trouble understanding the concept of fun. Did you have fun on your home planet?
Sure we did. The fun is hard to explain.
No, it's not. Fun is just like stuff that is fun.
I think what Jason 2.0 is trying to explain is that fun is
a thing that one has or does based on a human instinct or propensity to create a more pleasant phenomenological
It sounds like someone needs to do a little more research.
ScottBot, this sounds like a job for two chums with a ukulele and a drum.
I agree. So let's gear up and get to the planning table. We gotta figure out how we're gonna explain fun to a robot.
I think we are just about ready to start building this thing.
Yes.
What are you doing?
Well, you said we were making planes, so I was making planes.
I said plans. Where did this E come from?
It came off. I took it off of Wake Up.
Whack?
Yeah, you know, like a duck would say it.
A what?
A duck, like, whack up.
Wait. Why'd you mess the letters up?
I just thought making planes sounded a lot more fun than making plans.
How is that fun?
Well, I don't know, robot. It just is.
Then why does ScottBot seem to disagree?
Well, because ScottBot is not any fun.
No, I am fun. I'm just a different kind of fun.
It does not compute.
He's right. All we've done so far is mess around. You know what we need to do?
What?
Field work. Research. Huh?
That sounds fun.
Yes, it does.
Perfect.
Only thing we have to do is decide how to do it.
Animated self, puppet self, or self-self? I'm feeling pretty good in the skin I'm in, so I say self-self.
Agreed. We're on a mission. We're trying to explain fun to the musical robot.
How can we help?
Well, first of all, we need to know what is fun.
Analyzing.
What is fun? What is fun? What's something you enjoyed and you knew it when you were done? What is fun? What is fun? What's something you enjoyed and you knew it when you were done?
Swimming!
Skateboarding!
Video games!
Going to the gym.
Singing.
I like digging.
Digging?
Really? That sounds like work.
Yeah. Filling in holes is fun.
Whoa. Look at this.
What is it?
I don't know. Let's take it home. Look, everybody.
Now, what is that?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Well, what's it taste like?
Don't know.
Let me have a taste. Is hard a flavor?
Well, wait. This is obviously a hem noodle.
A what?
You know, a hem noodle. You use it to, well, everybody back up. Let me show you. Yeah, see, you sit on it like this. See? Ow. Perfect!
I don't know. I think it's supposed to go like this. Isn't that nice?
Yeah, maybe. Say, why do you kids bring this stuff home anyway?
Because it's fun!
You know what would be twice as fun?
What?
taking it back!
Oh, Dad!
Come on.
Your dad's right. I can hang my shawl on the bumpernickel.
Up, the kids can't hold back. They go out to the street, cause that's where the action's at. They're in a gang.
They're in a gang?
A bicycle gang.
How'd you know?
Cause I'm in it too. A bike has two wheels, a roll on the ground. It's the closest thing to fun that I've ever found. A bike has two wheels, a roll on the road. You know a 10-speed hero never gets old. We put our helmets on and take our training wheels off. We line up in formation as we roll around the block, spinning and grinning all along the street, waving hi to all the neighbors we meet. Sensing some trouble, we hit the brakes fast. You guys hear that? I think it was a cat. A bike has two wheels, a roll on the ground. It's the closest thing to find that I've ever found. A bike has two wheels, a roll on the road. You know a 10-speed hero never gets old. We hop off our bikes and we head to a tree where a little kitten's crying so pitifully. With the kitten in trouble, we have to act fast. You get on all fours and I'll stand on your back.
Ouch.
Teetering and wobbling, I reach for the cat, who takes a deep breath and jumps down from the branch to my helmet, then my shoulder, down my leg onto his back, and bounds across the lawn into the basket on the rack of Chloe's bike. And we all shout hooray! 10-speed hero saves the day. Because a bike has two wheels, a roll on the ground. It's the closest thing to find that I've ever found. A bike has two wheels, a roll on the road. You know a 10-speed hero never gets sold. Get on your bike and ride it around. Get on your bike and ride it around. Get on your bike and ride around town. Get on your bike. Ride it around, because the bike has two wheels, a roll on the ground. It's the closest thing to find that I've ever found. A bike has two wheels, a roll on the road. You know a 10-speed hero never gets old. A bike has two wheels, a roll on the ground. It's the closest thing to find that I've ever found. A bike has two wheels, a roll on the road. You know a 10-speed hero never gets old.
Riding bikes is some of the best fun ever.
Yeah, but why is that?
Well, because I get to choose what I'm doing.
Yeah, but some people ride bikes every day because they have to. Can't something you have to do also be fun?
Dang it! I don't know! More research?
Yeah. BTW?
Yeah?
My turn to ride the big bike, am I right?
Okay, but you gotta catch me first.
Jason 2.0 had a pretty solid point about how fun seems to happen when you get to do things that you choose to do. Natalie thought digging was fun. Well, some people dig all day, every day. They call it work, and they do not consider it fun.
Oh, sorry. We're gonna find out who has more fun digging a hole. The first group,
Group A,
is gonna have to dig a hole exactly how we say.
Whereas the second group,
Group Two,
B.
Oh.
They get to dig however they want. They get a lot more freedom.
That's right, and at the end, we'll see who had more fun doing it. Oh, Mrs. Teacher!
We heard there's a science break about to happen. Sounds like fun. So I brought over my after-school all-stars.
Perfect, we need two teams.
Great. Team A, B, A, B, A, B.
Come on.
A, run, let's go, and B. Yay.
Thanks, Mrs. Teacher. Boy, she's good. All right, I need you all to get some safety gear, a helmet, a vest, and some equipment. Line up over there, let's go to work. All right. Now, we got a lot to do here. We got a hole to dig. We don't have a lot of time to do it, so I want no chit-chat, all right? We got to dig this hole exactly 15 centimeters by 30 centimeters, okay? Let's get to work.
Come on, Team B. Come on over. Are you guys ready to have some fun?
Yeah.
Okay.
Here's what's gonna happen. I've got some shovels, okay? And I've got a place to dig. What do you guys want to dig for?
Treasure!
Treasure, okay, go get the shovels.
We're gonna peek.
Nice. All right, that's it, guys, you made it. You're all the way to the bottom, good work.
All right, both groups have finished digging. Let's see how they did. Group A, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much fun did you have?
A 2.
All right, Group B, doing the exact same job. How much fun did you guys have?
A lot.
A lot.
Wow. 8.
Okay. Well, that seems fairly conclusive, but I wonder if I could try something. Now, who's ready to help? What? What? Let's party!
Yeah. All right, you guys. You ready to help me fill in this hole? Let's end this right. Here we go. 1 shovel. 2 shovels. All right, and your turn. What? Anyone?
All right, how about we all go on an adventure? You ready? Let's go. Walking around the town. Let's go walking around the town. Nothing special, just walking around the town. We're going walking around the town. We're gonna walk around the town and stop and think. Are you thinking? I wonder if you're thinking what I'm thinking. 'Cause I'm thinking, what if we were frogs? What would we do then? Hop around the town. We're going hopping around the town. Like a frog, you might hop around the town. Let's hop around the town. We're gonna hop around the town. And then ribbit. Nice. You sound just like a frog. As long as we're using our imagination, we don't have to be something small. Let's be something big, like a dinosaur. Stomp around the town. We're gonna stomp around the town like a T-Rex, stomp around the town. Stomping around the town. We're gonna stomp around the town and then we'll roar. Wow, that was impressive. All right, now we gotta get over to the robot. How about we float like Bubble? Float around the town. We're gonna float around the town like a bubble would float around the town. Back to the robot, float around the town. We're gonna float around the town and then we'll stop and pop and drop.
Group 3 consists of Jason 2.0. We've left him all alone with a job he didn't want to do just to see if he would have fun doing it. If our last experiment was correct, since Jason didn't get to choose what to do, he shouldn't be able to have fun doing it. Let's check in on him and see how miserable he is.
Just a pirate playing on the sand, making sandcastles with my one good hand. I truly love the sea and I should hate the land, but with just one good hand, I don't swim too grand. So here I sit. Here I sit all alone. Just a pirate playing on the beach, dancing to the tune of a seagull's screech. My little lifeboat was just out of reach, and you can't do a quick step when you've got a peg leg. Just one good hand, I don't swim too grand. So here I sit tanning me pirate bones. I made a complicated map that leads to my treasure, but I'm such a sap. Who shall I give it to? Just a pirate playing on the sand, making sandcastles with my one good hand. I truly love the sea and I should hate the land, but with just one good hand, I don't swim too grand. And you can't do a quick step when you've got a peg leg. So here I sit tanning me pirate bones. Here I sit all alone. Here I sit tanning me bones.
Jason 2.0, return to the robot.
Roger.
A bike has two wheels and go on the road. You know a 10-speed hero never gets old.
You.
What were you doing having fun out there?
I didn't mean to. Yes.
You were clearly enjoying yourself.
Well, when I knew I had to do the work because everyone else took off and left me to do it, I figured there was only two ways to get it done.
What were those two ways?
Well, I could either be miserable and get the job done, or I could try to have a little fun doing it. So I pretended that I was a pirate burying treasure.
Wait a minute. So you're saying that you didn't get to choose what to do, but you chose to have fun doing it?
Yes, exactly. Rudy, come on down. I got something I want to run by you.
Hi, kids.
Hi, Rudy.
Rudy, nothing is fun.
Yeah. What?
We started out trying to make a list of fun things. Then we tried to see if maybe it was the ability to choose that made things fun. And then everybody else took off and made me work by myself. That's when I realized that fun comes from the inside and that you have to make the choice to have fun.
I think you're approaching an actual point, thanks to those kids.
Oh, hey, kids. Looks like Mrs. Teacher is here to pick you up. She's right outside the robot.
Oh, man, but thanks for coming. We couldn't have done this without you.
You guys,
seriously.
So great.
Five nice. For everybody.
Awesome.
Wonderful.
Good job,
Dutch.
Ouch.
Good
job.
Fantastic.
Man.
Well, boys. I'm off to oil the left elbow.
Later, skaters. Don't page me.
Birdie.
Well, musical robot, it's been a long day. But I think we have the answers that you were looking for. Fun is potentially everywhere.
Yeah, it's like air. Unless you're underwater, and then it's like water.
It's a choice you make. And no matter where you are or what you're doing, you can choose to have fun. Here are the studies we made and the data downloading now.
So digging holes is fun?
Well, it can be.
Are you having fun right now?
We're living inside a giant robot. Every day is fun.
Does not compute.
Really?
Really.
Are you having fun now?
Still having fun.
Bring it on. I mean, I could choose to hate this.
Yeah, but why, right?
Analysis seems to indicate that fun is not a thing that you do. Fun is a thing that you are.
Huh? I know one thing for sure. Having fun makes me really, really ready for bed.
Somebody unfolded all of your paper airplanes.
Yeah, you.
No.
It was me.
What? You didn't like my planes?
They were okay. I just wanted to see what the plans were for.
Well, what were they? Wait, they were plans for...
Yes.
Planes! Ready, set, rocket!
What is fun? What
ready
is fun?
To
what you enjoyed and you knew it when you were done. What is fun? What is fun? What's something you enjoyed and you knew it when you were done? What what is fun? What is fun? What's something you enjoyed and you knew it when you were done? What is fun? What is fun? What's something you enjoyed and you knew it when you were done? We'll be right back.